guys, in today's lecture we will see how the polymer's weight is calculated. See, here are the two ways to find out molecular weight of the polymer. First one is the number average molecular weight of the polymer, and second one is weight average molecular weight of the polymer. So we will start with the introduction. Initially, we have seen what is meant by polymer, monomer, how they can be synthesized, how they can be classified, and so on. So today we will see how the weight of the polymer can be calculated. So polymers are the long chains which consist of the repeating units of monomers all together, and they are joined by different methods like polyaddition, polycondensation, cross-linking, and so on. And polymers exhibit very different physical properties as compared to the monomers. For example, you can consider ethylene. So at room temperature and room pressure, the ethylene acts as a gas. But when by using polyaddition method, we can convert this ethylene to the polyethylene, it will be the solid. So obviously, gaseous component and the solid component have the different physical properties. And these properties will be changed according to the chain length. And the presence of small amounts of very long or very short chains can have drastic effects on their physical properties of the polymer. So consider here is the monomer, which contains 8 number of monomer units, and when we join these monomers to form a polymer, there is a long chain structure is formed. So repeating units makes up a polymer, and these repeating units were originally the monomer molecules. When polymer chains formed, their lengths and thus their weights were different. And it is very important to be able to characterize the polymer structure. It will be formed either by polyaddition, polycondensation, cross-linking on different methods. So determining the weight average molecular weight or the number average molecular weight is a part of any polymer characterization. So consider general, a monomer unit is here, and by adding same monomers by using polyaddition method, there is a formation of a long chain structure called as a polymer. So a monomer unit, see here, this is a repeating unit, and you can write n times this repeating unit is attached to the chain. Then now we'll find out the number average molecular weight. Before that, we will define how the number average molecular weight is calculated, and it is not very difficult to understand how the number average molecular weight can be calculated. So it is just that the total weight of the polymer molecule in a sample, and it is divided by the total number of polymer molecules which are present in a sample. So Mn is equal to summation of NiMi divided by summation of Ni is equal to summation of Wi divided by summation of Wi divided by Mi. Here Mn represents the, M represents molecular weight of each molecule, N represents the moles of molecules. Suppose consider the molecule or a polymer contains high number of moles, so N1, N2, N3 up to Ni number of moles are present in the sample. And M means the molecular weight of each molecule, so M1, M2, M3, M4 up to Ni number is there. So Mn represents the number average molecular weight, and is equal to summation of Ni into Mi divided by summation of Ni. It's equal to summation of Wi divided by summation of Wi upon Mi. So we know the number of moles into mass is equal to weight of the compound. So simply here written Wi, which is represents the weight of individual molecule, W1 plus W2 plus W3 up to Wi. And when we know Wi is equal to Ni Mi, so when we find out the value Ni, it will be Wi upon Mi. So this is the formula for calculating the number average molecular weight. Now the definition of weight average molecular weight. So weight average molecular weight can be represented by M by W, which is equal to summation of Ni Mi square divided by summation of Ni into Mi. So this is the formula to calculate weight average molecular weight, and the same is the definition of the weight average molecular weight. So consider a general example. There are three groups of the polymers and each group contains five chains, and three groups are there. So first one contains molecular weight 10,000, second one having 15,000, last one having 20,000 respectively. So from this data we want to calculate the number average and the weight average molecular weight of the polymer. So how this can be calculated? So see here, the molecular weight and the number average weight we will find first and then weight average. So initially number average molecular weight, I have written here formula m bar n. Bar represents the average, so m is the mass and n is the number. So number average molecular weight is equal to summation of ni mi divided by summation of ni. Here instead of I written x, so x number of moles will be there. So we have five number of, or we have three groups but chains are five, and having the weight is given respectively 10,000, 15,000 and 20,000. So you can write here 5 into 10,000. So n1 is a 5 and its weight or the mass is given 10,000. So this is the first bracket. So summation represents the sum or the addition. So you can add the second NIMI. So 5 into 15,000, this one second bracket, plus 5 into 20,000 divided by how many groups are there? Three groups and each having five chains. So 5 plus 5 plus 5. Three groups are there. So just add this summation of ni. N1, N2, N3. N1 is equal to 5, N2 is equal to 5, and N3 is equal to 5. So after calculating this, your number average weight will be 15,000. So what about average molecular weight? So we will find it. So weight average molecular weight can be calculated as M by W is equal to summation of Ni Mi square divided by summation of Ni Mi. Here instead of I, X is written. So simply just put all the values of Ni and Mi. So Ni's are 3, N1, N2 and N3. M values are given 3, 10,000, 15,000 and 20,000. Just put values at the respective places. So summation represents the each term. So first one is 5 into 10,000 square plus second term 5 into 15,000 square plus 5 into 20,000 square divided by 5 into 10,000 plus 5 into 15,000 plus 5 into 20,000. So answer will be 1611. So you can note down the weight average weight is always larger than the number average weight. And this is always true except in the case when all the chains are the same length. And we can recall the polydispersity, which is equal to M bar W divided by M bar N, which is greater than or equal to 1. Now we will see one example. In the sample of polymer, which contains 100 molecules having the molecular weight 1000 and 200 molecules having the molecular weight 10,000 and other 200 molecules having molecular weight 1,00,000. So calculate M bar N and M bar W. So there are the three bunches of the molecules. So first one contains 100 molecules, that is N1 is equal to 100 and the molecular weight is 10 raised to 3 or mass is equal to 10 raised to 3. So you can write here 10 raised to 3 for first segment. For second, 200 molecules are included and 10 raised to 4 number of mass is there. So N2 is equal to 200 and the mass is 10 raised to 3, sorry, 10 raised to 4, that is 10,000. And last segment is of 200 molecules. So N3 is equal to 200 and the molecular weight is given around 1,00,000. So you can write here 10 raised to 5, that is M3. So N1, M1, N2, M2, N3, M3s are with us. So we can calculate M bar N and M bar W. So see here, initially I have calculated number average molecular weight. So just you can write down the formula. M bar N is equal to summation of Ni Mi divided by summation of Ni. So for your consideration, I have written all the values separately. This summation sign can be written as We have three groups. So N1 M1 plus N2 M2 plus N3 M3 divided by addition of all number of moles N1 plus N2 plus N3. So by this way you can simplify this equation and write here. So your N1 value is 100 and M1 value is 10 raised to 3. From this I have written values. 100 into 10 raised to 3 plus second one is 200 into 10 raised to 4 and last one is the 200 into 10 raised to plus 5 divided by 100 plus 200 plus 200. These are the values of N1, N2 and N3. So this will be 500. So just calculate on your calculator and it will be 44,200. So you can write unit if you want, it will be in gram. Then weight average molecular weight is calculated as m by w is equal to summation of nimi square divided by summation of nimi. Just if you want you can simplify equation as like this: n1 m1 square plus n2 m2 square plus n3 m3 square divided by n1 m1 plus n2 m2 plus n3 m3 and write down the values. So n1 is 100, m1 is 10 raised to 3, just do it square, plus 200 into 10 raised to 4, do it square, plus 200 into 10 raised to 5, do it square, divided by this one as it is, n1 m1 plus n2 m2 plus n3 m3 and find out the value or the answer of all this. So it will come m by w is equal to 91,402. So here you can write unit as a gram. So this is the weight, average molecular weight of the given polymer. Now there is another problem which is of same type. So problem is here: in a polymer example there are 50 polymer molecules of molecular weight 10 raised to 2. So 50 polymer molecules having molecular weight is 10 raised to 2. So just write down N1 and this is a M1. So I have written here data. N1 is equal to 50 and M1 is equal to 10 raised to plus 2. And 200 polymer molecules having the molecular weight 10 raised to 3. So just number of molecules, that is the N2, which is equal to 200. And the molecular weight or the mass is given 10 raised to 3. And N3 is given 100 molecules having the molecular weight 10 raised to 4. So by same method you can calculate the number average molecular weight and the mass average molecular weight. So I have calculated this, and number average molecular weight m bar n is equal to summation of ni mi divided by summation of ni. It comes for this problem 3442.85, and the weight average molecular weight m bar w is equal to summation of ni mi square divided by summation of ni mi. Put all the values in this formula and its answer will come 5927.07 grams.